Good evening.
Maybe it's a touch too dark, Ned.
Oh my God, oh went my to God. See a great film tonight. Went look. This afternoon. Look at Toffee.
Are you in it?
Oh my God, she's so funny. Let them see her. Move over.
Are you in it?
She's hilarious. She's the funniest dog. She literally talks to you.
Yeah.
She knew there was going to be a live. She's pulled her blanket out of her basket and put it there right in the centre so that you can see her.
Nina Sosania.
Look. Oh God, she's probably going to start shagging it now.
Yeah, if she starts humping her
rug. It's really weird the way she humps it because she's a girl, but she humps like a boy.
I thought she was about to take a poo.
Imagine.
Guys, first question I want to ask you is, why did they call it Screw and not Screws? Why do you think, Ned? Because it's not about one screw.
Do you think they should have called it Screws? I loved Prisoner Cell Block H. Somebody said, do you know what? I used to be a massive fan of Prisoner Cell Block H. This is before Hey You and Housewives of Beverly Hills and everything. That was my original crap TV.
Was it? Crack TV.
Crack
TV.
Prisoner...
Cell Block H.
I have
to confess, it had this cult status. I tried about six times, and every time I tried, I fucking hated it. If I'm honest, Prisoner Cell Block H. Because you never felt the prisons were real, the cells were real, because every time they shut a cell door, it would wobble.
Yeah. No, but that was the point. But it was complete crap, and it was never trying to be anything else.
Yeah. Yeah. Anya Lynch says definitely should be called Screws. I thought you said Scrooge on Instagram.
What was the old one with Boogie Withers or Doogie Withers or Boogie Withers?
Gooby
what,
Withers.
What was her name?
Hoobie Doobies.
What was Within These Walls?
Within these walls.
I used to love that. I used to watch that when I was a kid with my mum. I loved it. What are the other prison dramas?
Porridge.
Well, that's not a drama. That's comedy, but it was
I beg to differ.
I loved it so much.
Drama comedy. It was because it didn't have candle after. It wasn't one of those old fashioned comedies where you know they were steering you as to when to laugh. I think Screw. Nadia said one of the writers. She said the writer of Killing Eve wrote this. I said a writer of Killing Eve will have written this.
Bad Girls. Yes, that's another one, yeah. Dawny.
But I wasn't entirely convinced this show knew what it was.
No, because in the break, I looked it up, and apparently it's a comedy drama.
Well,
I love 24 Hours in Police Custody. I much prefer to watch it.
But you really like Orange is the New Black.
No, I did, but then it just got too...
What?
It was too many vaginas in it. It was just too much.
Okay.
I mean, proper vagina.
Laura Lawler agrees. Who else agrees? It didn't know whether to go for the comedy or the drama.
No.
And so consequently it fell between two stools. Because the story around the boy who recognised the guy who came in, who he thought was a paedophile, that was quite serious. And I thought that was quite well played by that young actor. I thought that was quite dark. And then the other chap who kept popping up saying, can someone listen to me? And then he was upset because the apple crumble was off the menu.
Mm.
That was potentially quite funny.
Mm. I mean, the comedy person in it is the Asian guy, isn't it? That's a fact.
Yeah.
But I actually felt there was a real problem with the direction. The actors didn't seem comfortable and there was a lot of acting rather than being.
I thought the girl from Derry Girls, what's her name? Because the main woman in it, Nina Sosania, she was in, wasn't she in that...
Loads of things.
What was that series we loved set up in Yorkshire? And she was the girlfriend of Sarah Lancashire, wasn't she?
Mm.
She's great. I mean, to be honest with you, I felt Nina Sosania was wandering around. There was a lot of wandering around, which I guess there must be in prisons, but I thought it was at its strongest when they weren't wandering around.
Mm.
Someone there just said it was terrible. Who was that? Who said that? That's very strong. Come off the fence. Georgina Demetrio, it was terrible. Alison Fisher thought it was a bit slow. Dawny Harvey, I agree, it didn't make too much sense.
It was just so clunky.
I didn't really
clunky.
Understand where they were going.
It was just so clunky. There was no
It was as clunky cohesion. As a cell lock.
I just didn't... And maybe you're right, it's because it's billed as a comedy drama...
Oh, look, Reese says here, look, hey, guys, I really didn't like it, if I'm being honest. Really liked Nina as the main actress, but felt the oddball tone along with some of the other acting and plot lack needs gritty tone. Nadia at one point said the music was like listening to a bunch of men in a side room banging dustbin lids on their head.
Mm. And then it
felt, I couldn't shake that
and
image.
And then after a while, it all felt a bit Heidi High.
Well, yes, at one point, with the tannoy, ding dong ding.
It was like Heidi Hello, High of Heidi prisons.
Heidi High campers. And I also felt that Tango and Halifax, thank you, Elijah. I also felt one of the weaknesses, one of the strengths of these shows is when you have all those background actors and all the background characters and all those incidental interactions that happen, like the guy who said he was claustrophobic. Unfortunately, too many of those characters in this for me were just standing up, saying their line and then walking off, rather than really, you know, not occupying their space within
Missy
a prison.
Missy Hawkins, I wanted it to be gritty. And in fact, we were warned of its grittiness before it started.
Yeah.
I mean, Karen the grittiest Busby. We got was a smelly bullfrog.
Karen Busby asks a killer question. Why the fuck was there a bullfrog there? Well, I said to Nads, clearly when she took it out in the Tupperware box, they were striking for a huge metaphor of the bullfrog that
didn't want to leave.
To
be free, like she didn't want to be free, like she couldn't leave.
But what did I say? They just need to tip the...
Yeah,
Tupperware
it wouldn't hop out. You just needed to tip it.
I said, just tip. But then that would have destroyed the metaphor. So if I was there, though, as the actor, I'd say, well, I only need to do that and it'll jump out.
I said, well, but I was going to watch it. I'm not now. I don't think we'll be watching episode two.
I don't know. I thought the young girl from Derry Girls, she's a cracking little actress. What's her name? Jamie Lee O'Donnell. She was good, but... Even her rookie nature was straight out of the handbook of how to be a rookie screw.
I think they struggle with the writing. I think the writing was a real problem. Chemistry lacking, exactly, Steph.
Come on.
There was no cohesion. There was no believability.
No. What else? You can watch them all on More 4. Chemistry lacking, Steph Schultz. Mm. The lead, I think, isn't right for comedy. Tracy Lynam kills an hour on a Thursday night.
It wasn't a comedy.
No, it wasn't a comedy, was it? I mean, it really wasn't.
And when they have been trailing it, they've gone for gritty, not comedy.
Yeah. Reem AW says, I thought it was going to be a dead animal at first. Well, I was hoping terribly it was going to be a dead inmate.
I thought it was going to be a foot.
Yeah, oh.
Or a hand.
I thought it was going to be a piece of something.
Because we were told it was gritty and it was going to be shocking. And we had a warning. I didn't know it was going to be a bullfrog.
Yeah, no.
I mean, that's hardly gritty and shocking.
It's pretty random, isn't it? And no one's on. What about the scene?
What was Four Lives? Somebody's saying Four Lives is good on BBC.
Well, that was
we missed that. We should have done that, shouldn't we?
But the thing that made me really just gag with ridiculousness was when she was talking to the guy who'd come in to check her and ask for ask for her birth certificate and suggest that the old guard are out and a new guard are in. And she kept looking off over to the... She'd do this.
Because a man on
and
Spice.
And there was a man on Spice with a bullfrog on his
lap. But why was he suddenly in reception when he'd been told to be hidden?
I know. I mean, was that meant to be funny? Was it meant to be funny?
Oh, Laura, that's exactly what I was saying. I said the guy at the end is gonna kill himself, the one that nobody
listened to. Yeah, that's what we thought, but we didn't realise it was about Apple Crumble. Shelley Ridler, I agree, think the blonde screw could have some comic potential. Yeah, she's quite sort of throwaway, isn't she?
I mean, maybe we should watch another episode.
No, I think so. Hang on, Lynette Griffith, thank you very much. You probably heard me reference it, and the hooded guy at the end. Did anyone notice when he said, are you in it? And then he turned round. I'm going to show you the walk he did. This is, not forget, this is for a guy who's going to use a screw to get drugs and all sorts of stuff in. This is how he walked off at the end of the show. Are you in it? Good, are you in it? And he went like this.
He did a bit.
What the fuck?
Hang on,
I can do the whole thing, look. Are you in it? Good. it's not menacing.
Yeah, it was hardly menacing, was it?
Go back and check his walk.
She's going to be caught in a terrible situation because she's going to have to bring drugs in because she's too scared.
And she's a rookie.
She's going out at night on her own.
Mincing. He was mincing. He was sashaying away with joy that he'll be able to get, I don't know, a hairdryer in or something.
Oh, God.
So there you go. There's our first review of 2021. First TV review.
What a smasher.
Guys, subscribe if you haven't and put your comments down below. And tell us if it's your first time coming
to the channel, we do loads here. And tomorrow morning at 10:30, we would be doing... We'll have to check what Tommy Oglot is. We will be doing Coffee Money.
2022. Thanks, guys. I keep saying 2021. I do. Yeah. I don't feel like we had 2021. And yeah, as someone quite beautifully put it there, we were all screwed tonight. So on that note, arrivederci.